I'm Bruce McEwen, a professor and head of the Laboratory of Neuroendocrinology at the Rockefeller University in New York City.
What is good stress versus bad stress?
Well, stress as a single word is used to cover many different things with many different meanings. So for example, good stress, giving a talk, taking an exam, doing something that has a good outcome, you feel good about it. There's something called tolerable stress. When something bad happens, then if you have the resources internally and with external support from friends, you can weather the storm and show recovery, resilience, and recovery. Then there's something called toxic stress that really speaks for itself. Something bad happens, and you don't have those internal or external support systems, and it can create real health problems. And so I guess what we have to do is to qualify use of the word stress, if we say it at all, by saying good stress or toxic stress or something to really point out which direction the body is going.
How does stress affect your body?
When we undergo stress or almost anything, getting up out of bed in the morning, going through our daily activities, even if we don't call it stress per se, we have systems. Our cortisol, our autonomic nervous system, adrenaline, our metabolic hormones, our immune system are all activated, and they help us adapt, and they keep us alive during the day. We don't call that stress. The term for it is allostasis, the active process of adapting. And normally, when these things are turned on and turned off at the right time, they keep us alive and we do very well. But when they are not turned on when needed or not turned off when no longer needed, then they can cause problems and they contribute to this thing I call toxic stress.
How do men and women react differently to stress?
Men's and women's brains are actually wired differently. And as a result, men and women react to stressors in different ways. We say men and women do many of the same things equally well, but they use different strategies and different circuits. And so as a result, you'll have women being more prone, for example, to depressive illness, men more prone for substance abuse and antisocial behavior under chronic stress. And these are just illustrations of the fact that the brains really are different.
For more information, please visit nccih.nih.gov.